Hi friends, welcome to my channel M2K Tutorials. So in this video we're gonna learn about the JavaScript event. So as you know, in our previous video we have learned about the HTML DOM elements events, okay? And there you have noticed that we were adding the events in our HTML itself, but we can avoid that to use those events in our HTML, and we can use purely JavaScript to implement the events on any elements. So in order to do that, let me remove this one and we're gonna see almost the same example using the JavaScript. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so to add any JavaScript event, first what we need to do, the first thing we need to do, the get the reference of the element. So in our case, this is our div, and what I want to do after clicking on this div, this simple div, I want to change the color of this div. So first we need to get the reference of this div. So we already have id here. So in our JavaScript file, what we need to get the element's reference. So what we can do, we can create one variable and then using document dot get element by id, and id is simple div. For our div, what we can do, we just getting the reference of our div element. Now using this reference, we can attach the event to this element. So for that, JavaScript provide one method, add event listener. So we gonna use that. So you add event listener, and then add event listener use three parameters. The first parameter is the name of your event. So in our case, we want click event. So if you notice, in HTML element, when we were using the events, we were using on with them, so on click, on mouse over, like that. But here you only need the click or mouse over, not on mouse over. Okay, so not on click, only click. The second parameter we need to pass is the function or the method which we want to call after click happened, after event happened. So in our case, let's say I want to change the color of this div. So I'm just calling one method, change div color. Okay, now we don't have this method yet, so let's define that as well. So function change div color. Okay, so we created one function, and let me just for now add one alert to just check that whether this method is calling after clicking on the div. So method called, let's say I'm just alerting things. And there is third parameter, which is the use capture parameter. So we will discuss more in this video about that part, but currently you have to understand the third parameter by default is false. So if you don't provide it, that's also okay. We're gonna discuss after some time. Okay, so now we need to just save it, refresh and click on it, and you can see after clicking on it, I am seeing this alert message. So it means after clicking, we are able to call this function. Okay, now time to change the color of this div. So one thing you need to remember, if you want to change the color of the same element where you have added your event, so we are adding event on div element, okay, and you are just calling this method. So in this method, if you write this, it will be actually same as writing div element. So div element and this is same. Okay, so we are writing this, and then we need to change. So we have to use style, as you know, and then background property, we're gonna change it to, let's say, red. Okay, that's it. And if you refresh it and click on it, and voila, you are able to see your red colored div after clicking on it. So what happened here, we added one element in our div element, then we called one method, and that method is changing the color of our element where event was attached. Okay, so this is one thing. Now other thing is that sometime what you need to do, you may need to pass the parameter to your your events. Okay, so in order to do that, if you notice here, we are not using parenthesis with the functions. So if you call if you are use this parenthesis, what happened, as soon as this line will execute, it will call this method, but we don't want that, wanted that, right? We wanted to only execute this method when click event is happened. So we can't put this parenthesis here. So obviously we can't pass the parameter here if parenthesis is not there. So to work around of that, you can create one anonymous function, and we already discussed that is in our data type video. So what is an anonymous function, and we also discuss in our function. So what you can do, you can create one anonymous function, and then you can pass your parameter. So in this case, let's say I am passing one color, okay, and I am taking this color here in our function, and then we are assigning that color to our div. But there will be one problem. So now this your change div color method is inside this anonymous function. So now this will be not having the reference of this div element. So to resolve that issue, what you can do, you can pass this target or the event object. This is by default event object you will be getting from this event, okay. Then you can also pass this one, okay, and then in your method you can use that and ev.target. There is this method which will get you the same element which is having this add event listener. So using that one you can still do the same thing. Now you are passing the dynamic colors. So if you pass black, let's say, and refresh it, click on it, and you are able to see the effect, okay. You want to add, means like in the same element you can add multiple event as well. So let's say I'm adding this mouse over as well, and after, okay, O should be small, and using that again after mouse over, you can see this color is changing, okay. Mouse over, color is changing, okay. So you can add multiple event in one element. Now in some cases you also want to remove this events, so you can remove those event as well. So using that, let's say I'm creating one button to just to show you that how to remove the event. So let's say I'm creating one button, remove click event here, okay, and again I will get the ID of let's say name it, give this ID event remover. So ID of this button is event remover, and here I will again create something like this, okay. I will get the reference of button, we can name it as button lm, and now in this button lm I will add one event, and here I can just create an anonymous function, and inside that what I can do, I will just write the same, I will take the same element where I had added the event, and then I will use remove event listener, and then I will pass the method which was passed method. So if you see the remove event signature, method signature is the same as event listener signature, okay. If you see after clicking on it, I am able to change the color, right? But let's say I refresh it, click on remove click event, now event is not working because that event got removed, okay. So this is the way we can remove the event. Now as you have seen earlier, I was talking about the third parameter, which is true or false, and the name was use capture, okay. So by default it's false, use capture, and if you can make it true, you can make it true. So there is two phases, use capture and bubbling phase. So how event works, event propagate, right? So let's say if it's moving from the actual your element to the root. Let's say I'm clicking on this button and the event moving from this button to div, then body, then head, and so on till the root. So it will call the bubbling phase. So this will work from your target to your root, so it will be called bubbling phase. But if phase is capture phase, so what will happen? Event will propagate, event will see that whether first your root elements, and then it will go down to your target elements. So it will be like first your parents div and all those elements will be registered, and then your target event will be registered. So what happened if, let's say, this div also have the click event and this button also have the click event? So if you are using bubbling phase, so your button's event will be trigger first and then your div click event will be trigger after the button. But let's say if you are using capturing phase, so what will happen? This div event will happen first and then your button event will happen after that, because in our HTML button is inside our div. Actually it's not, so let me just put it here. Okay, and now if we click on the remove element, so first your button element event is triggered because currently it's using bubbling phase, and then your div element event is triggered. Okay, so first your child elements and then your parent elements. Okay, but if we just change this false to true, it means now it's using the capturing phase. So now I'm changing it to true here, and now if we click on this one here, you can see div elements triggered, then button elements is triggered. So what happened? It's running from parent to child. Okay, so this is for the capturing phase. So yeah, this is pretty much it guys for the JavaScript events. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If please subscribe to my channel and comment in the comment box if you have any query or doubt, so that I can answer all of them. Okay, happy coding.